All right, it's my pleasure to welcome you to Football Mania once again. You know, the celebration continues after Chelsea beat Manchester City 1-0 to win the 2021 UEFA Champions League. I mean, the fans enjoyed themselves. The Chelsea owner, Roman Abramovich, was also there. Everybody had fun. As you can see, I'm doing this review very, very late because I also had fun, had to enjoy myself, had to, savour the moment. It was a wonderful occasion, and it's not something that happens every year. This is the second time Chelsea is winning the UEFA Champions League. Stopping Manchester City winning their first makes it even more beautiful, makes it even more, delightful, because Chelsea went into this particular match as underdogs. Nobody gave them a chance. Pundits, everybody, they were saying, no chance, it's only Manchester City, because they thought Manchester City wanted it more than Chelsea, and also because Chelsea, you know, had a couple of missed results towards the end of the season, so in the league and also in the FA Cup, losing the FA Cup to Leicester City. So many people doubted the Blues, but the Blues always rise to the occasion. I mean, when everybody doubts Chelsea, that's when you see their best. And the boys were at their best against Manchester City. Like, first and foremost, let's talk about the tactical aspect of the game, how the game unfolded. Chelsea started with their usual 3-4-2-1 formation. Manchester City started with 4-3-3, as I predicted in the preview show. And knowing Guardiola, he thinks a lot, so he's never going to do something, you know, we have already seen something that he wasn't successful with. So he's ever going to do something new, but he took it to another level, a whole new level. Talking about using 6 attacking midfielders without a defensive midfielder, without a striker. And it was one hell of a bold move. Actually, the lineup wasn't reason why they lost. Because I said in the preview show that it's not about the players, because people were giving excuses that he rested players in the FA Cup and then in the league against Chelsea. People were giving excuses, but I said in that preview show that it was not about the players. It was about the setup. Our setup is very, very difficult for him to overcome, just like a Liverpool setup, you know, a few years ago against them. You know, they always struggle with a setup like that, and I knew that he was ever going to try something incredible. But at the end of the day, he tried something incredible, but it didn't pay, it didn't work out. It was like, it was even worse than what he has used before. So that's a kudos to Thomas Tuchel, because at the moment he has played Guardiola 3 times since he arrived in England, and he has won 3 times against Guardiola. Now, it's not an easy feat. Anybody who, in fact, Guardiola is arguably the GOAT manager in world football, arguably the greatest manager in ever in history of football. So you understand that pedigree, and then understand what Thomas Tuchel was able to manage against him in all the meetings, 3 meetings, 3 wins. Incredible, with a Chelsea squad that he has trained for less than 4 months or 5 months thereabout. He arrived in January. So he's a massive feat, you know, for Thomas Tuchel and also for Chelsea. Now, talking about the deployment of tactics, you know, what actually went wrong with Manchester City's tactics, you know, was that they didn't have penetration, because Chelsea didn't give them the gap to penetrate. And one of the reasons why Pep Guardiola played 6 midfielders, 6 attacking midfielders who are very, very technical, is because he knew that he was going to struggle with spaces in between lines. So he wanted to have people who are very good on the ball, who can play 1-2 passes and then, you know, try to set themselves free in between lines. But still, Chelsea were able to manage the lines comfortably well, and then man-marked almost everyone. I mean, is one hell of a tactical masterpiece by Thomas Tuchel. The lines were so narrow, and the defensive line was so high. The 2 number 10s, talking about Mason Mount and Kai Havertz, were also inside, and then Timo Werner was running upside down everywhere, every channel, every space. He was there. He was everywhere. In fact, one of the reasons why Thomas Tuchel, you know, took him off after 60 something minutes because he ran himself to the ground. He walked like a madman. He never stood still. So what is one of the reasons why Chelsea are able to contain teams, because when you look at most teams are technically very good. Some have individual brilliance, some have technically gifted players, high quality technically gifted players. Some teams just win because they work harder than others. And in this Chelsea team, we have people who can give you a lot of legs. Talking about N'Golo Kante, who was the man of the match, Timo Werner, Kai Havertz ran and ran and ran and ran. But the difference with Kai Havertz and Timo Werner is Timo Werner has been playing in recent matches. Kai Havertz, you know, hasn't been playing because he was injured, you know, in recent matches. So he had enough rest, but he put in a huge shift, you know, last night and cap it off with a brilliant goal, courtesy of a brilliant pass by Mason Mount. You know, that found him in the 42nd minute, and he rounded the goalkeeper, you know, to slot in to give Chelsea 1-0 lead. And that goal eventually won the match for Chelsea. Going back to the tactics again, you know, Pep Guardiola found it very, very difficult, you know, to make spaces in between the lines, you know, to be able to take players on. Because the way Chelsea play their three at the back, you know, most people think where they play three at the back and they have a flat defense, you know, when they are defending. No, the Rudiger and the side center backs, Rudiger and Azpilicueta, they always come inside tracking their men. So when they are defending, if they have a number 10, if they have an opponent number 10 that is inside, they always go inside. One of them, not two of them at a time, one at a time, will always go inside to mark a number 10. So it's a flexible formation that works very well for the team. The shape is great. The functionality is great. Everything is great about the formation, considering the personnel Chelsea have at the club. We do not have a match winner, you know, we do not have the best players in the world, we do not have a Haaland or an Mbappe or Messi or Ronaldo, we do not have that. So we have to work collectively and bring out the best out of the team collectively. So that's exactly what they did against Manchester City, and they overcame everything that Manchester City, you know, had to offer. In fact, they offered so little. I mean, they offered so little. If you look at the count, the shot counts, we had more shots, we had more opportunities, we had more big chances to win that game by more than one or two goals. So Manchester City, I can count one big chance they had, apart from a Foden's shot that was blocked by Rudiger earlier in the game. So they didn't really, you know, pose much threat to Chelsea. It was a kind of flat performance by them. Pep Guardiola was more than a confused man, couldn't do anything, make any meaningful impact in the game tactically. So it was weird in a way, because that's not Pep Guardiola. And in the second half, Chelsea dropped deeper a little bit because at that moment, you know, Manchester City, we are throwing everything at them, you know, committing more players forward, chasing a goal. Chelsea had to buy their time, sit a little bit deeper, you know, try to counter. And they countered, you know, one or few times and then created a huge chance, which Pulisic, you know, missed narrowly. But all the same, it was a professional performance in the second half. The first half was much more better, but it was a more professional performance in the second half. It was all about containing Manchester City. You know, but at the end of the day, even if you look at it that way, Manchester City did so little even in that second half. Let me borrow the words of Arsene Wenger: Chelsea, we are even more comfortable in the second half than in the first half, because in the first half, Manchester City went behind them a few times, had a few opportunities. In the second half, they didn't have that clear opportunity. They didn't have that clear route to go in behind. They didn't have that clear opportunity at goal. So they didn't have that, even though they were more on the ball than they were in the first half. All right, if you enjoyed this video, just like, subscribe, hit the notification button, and then comment below and tell us what you think about the final and also about the video itself. See you next time.